Man, my boy Iti right here.
Yeah, Iti, great job there, bro.
Brother. I mean, I didn't do anything except fight the fish. You know, the man put us on it. So sick. Well, what an amazing fish.
Beautiful, amazing fish, dude.
Va a ver, papá. Va a ver hasta dónde va a llegar ese gallo. No sancocho.
What does that mean?
Sancocho, that's the nickname you get given when you miss fish on live bait. You didn't miss your fish on live bait, you got rocked. But we nicknamed you Sancocho because we love you, buddy.
Karma's
Well, we're backing down on this fish. Oliver's into something on the line.
Man, round two, baby.
Round two.
It's been maybe 10 minutes.
Oh, we're going to run out of line again.
Since we got that first rooster.
We're on to something else here.
Yep. On again.
Yeah, baby.
That was sick. It's a Costa Rican workout.
Yes, sir. Like we talked about on the beach, we don't go to the gym. We go fishing.
Screamer.
How's that feeling, dude? Does it feel different than the other one? Bigger?
Hard to say, you know? With this heavy gear, man, it all kind of feels the same initially until you get a visual on it. And I'm not really feeling anything like dramatically different as far as like head shakes or this fish wanting to come up to the surface or anything.
Now, how would you classify these roosters fight-wise?
It's comparable to most saltwater fish in that class. You know, yep. Iti, how big was that last rooster?
12 kilos, maybe? 10? Yeah, about 10. So that's like 23, 24 pounds.
Okay, yeah.
You know, we're using a little bit heavy gear for them, but we got to use that heavy gear.
Around some deep water pinnacles and stuff.
Right? Yep, we got to use that heavy gear because you can easily get a 25-pounder. It could be a 75-pounder. They hang out in the same spots. Could have, you know, we released one last year. It was 98 pounds. World record's about 115 right now.
That is a big rooster.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, I'm curious to see what we have here this time. This one's coming up to the surface now.
We'll see what it is here in a minute.
I'm no longer Sancocho.
No more Sancocho.
No mas. One of the biggest things about the traveling aspect of this fishing, man, is staying loose and being able to adapt, right?
Totally.
I come into this tackle store outside of San Jose, Costa Rica, and thinking, you know, I'm going to see something that I'm used to seeing back at home. And it is a dope shop. What was your boy's shop?
Stone Mountain Outdoors, run by my buddy Mark Evans.
Yeah, man. But, you know, the selection's kind of limited.
Well, yeah. You know, and down here, we don't have many people that are fishing high-end stuff.
Right.
We make do with what we got, but
bro, we're whooping them on the old school.
The old school, the ugly sticks. They put fish in the boat.
You know, my very first rod and reel was a $14.99 Kmart, you know, spin cast combo.
Exactly.
From Shakespeare.
Yep.
So
they're not the prettiest, not the lightest, but they do the job.
And when you grow up like I did, you know, with look at that guy.
Look at that.
He just slowed down right there, but
love the sound of that.
You grow up with, you know, the bare minimums, man. You really learn to appreciate high-end gear.
Exactly.
At the end of the day. Like, Aaron's been flipping out fishing that Tranx the last 2 days.
I love it.
It just makes the experience that much better. Let's get a couple over my shoulder shot. And really, just like any other big game fish, you know, you want to keep the pumping down to a minimum. You keep that rod bent, you know, whether we're fishing roosters or fishing smallmouth bass in Wisconsin, that rod's acting like a shock absorber.
That's right.
You know, you take what the fish gives you. You see that big head shake right there? That kept that fish from pulling the hook. You don't want to overdo it, but don't at the same time, don't be afraid to put pressure on them. This is is heavy gear. There she goes again.
Yeah, I mean, I'm running 40-pound braid on my Tranx because I want more casting distance. Yeah,
absolutely. There's always trade-offs.
Exactly. You're using that heavier line, you can put more herd on them. But if we get something in really deep water,
you don't have as much line capacity.
You don't have as much line capacity.
But you hope, you know, the heavier drag that you can put on them, you know, can compensate for that.
And then sometimes, like with that shark the other day, when you're maxed on your drag, you got to thumb the spool.
Oh, yeah.
And lock down.
Especially when your rod doesn't have enough lifting power.
Yep. Like that thing, that'll lift everything. That ugly stick, you could lift an engine block on that rod.
You're not going to feel too many bites. But...
Nope.
Yeah, I so badly wanted to, like, bring in my, like, high-end mega bass destroyers that are totally capable of whooping all this stuff.
Totally, dude.
But, like, you know, flying out of country for the first time, having to deal with a big checked-in rod tube. Like, I wasn't down for that. And this thing's got to be bigger, huh?
Hey, it's putting up... Much better fight.
Yeah, absolutely it is.
You know, there it goes again. Como lo siente?
Come on. Yeah, see, every time I see that rod tip, you know, loosen up, I just crank down.
That's right.
Nice and easy.
I was taught when I was a kid, learning how to fish, because, I mean, I grew up handlining down here in Costa Rica. But when I was first taught how to fish with a rod and reel, it was actually Mark from Stone Mountain. He bought me my first rod and reel. And he said, keep it at like 2 o'clock or like a 60 degree angle.
Yeah.
And that's held true, you know.
And if you don't know what 60 degrees looks like, you guys should have paid attention in school.
Yep, that's right. Math skills.
Hey. Yeah.
What run is that now?
Gosh, 10 or 12 probably. Good thing is we got most of our line back.
Yeah.
That first one almost dumped the spool.
Yep.
Which is pretty impressive for a 20-pound fish.
Well, they fight well above their weight class.
Must be that mohawk, huh?
I think so. It makes them badass. They're punk rockers, that's for sure.
Fruit today.
Beautiful conditions today, man.
You called it, bro. You know?
Iti called it. Iti's like, let's come out Monday afternoon. Uh-huh. We'll come fishing because it's after the storm blew through. And look at this. We got beautiful, beautiful surface conditions.
You know, that's why I'm glad I'm down here for a week, to be honest.
Exactly. Costa Rica.
You just don't know what you're going to be dealt with as far as conditions. And the first couple days are rough, man. Like, steady, 15, 20 mile an hour wind.
That second day out, that was rough, dude. Big swell. You fell down. I almost fell out of the boat.
I ate shit for the first time in my life. And today's just absolutely gorgeous.
We got Mr. Rooster in the back there just smiling his ass off. Hi, Ethy, what do you think, buddy?
You're good at what you do, my man.
That's why I fish with these guys, man. I've been fishing with these guys since I was like 10 years old.
Like you said, family, huh? What was that?
Something else. There's fish everywhere.
Yeah. Ethy should be throwing a popper.
Nope. So if we get a double header on something, lines are out.
Oh, yeah.
I've had it happen before.
Well, see, it's funny because, like, grew up in SoCal, we fish cattle boats, right?
Yeah, I mean, exactly.
A light load is 30 people.
Holy crap.
A light load. That's limited, they call it.
Yeah, limited. That's like an exclusive VIP trip almost.
You know, and you learn how to fish as a team.
Yep.
And go in and out and avoid the whole basket weaving process when you got 10 to 30 guys all hooked
exactly.
up.
Exactly. So my buddy Gary I was telling you about from the roastery?
Yeah.
He used to be a guide on a party boat in Florida.
Oh, okay.
And he was telling me stories of, you know, having 80 people on a boat and have a big wahoo come through and rip a bunch of lines up and yeah. Damn, son.
Bro, that's why this guy just doesn't want to come
up. We're pushing
up.
10 minutes now,
I'm
buddy.
I'm hoping it's a big snapper or something.
I don't know. He doesn't know. Ethy doesn't know.
So, like, now I'm getting a little impatient. I'm putting just a little bit of pressure on the line when I lift up.
Yeah, because we got 80-pound braid. What do we have for leader, Ethy? 100-pound? 100-pound leader and a big circle hook.
We did leave a little section of 50-pound fluoro on there, though. So I don't want to hammer it too hard.
No.
But, you know, just that little bit of extra pressure on the thumb is letting me lift the rod up so I can wind
it
up.
And how are you doing that? Are you pinching it against the foam?
Not completely. Just enough tension. It's just You know, it's a real fine line.
Yeah, and that's a lot different than thumbing the spool.
Yeah.
You know, and those are skills you learn after how many years of fishing, buddy?
Bro, not enough.
But not enough. It's never time. Enough.
But a long time, bro. Long time. Can't ever give you guys my age.
No, how many years have you been fishing now?
Gosh. People know that I started fishing when I was 10.
Exactly.
So.
And you never stop learning, right?
No, it never stops, man.
Never stops. You always go to somewhere different. Like, there's different parts of Costa Rica I'll go and people fish different. And the techniques that I use here don't work there. You know, that's a cool thing when I travel around with the National Fishing Club and the kayak circuit.
Mm-hmm.
Everywhere is a different challenge.
Yeah, and you know, the new perspectives just make you a better overall angler, even if you're a species-specific guy.
Yep.
Oh, gosh. Just going to have a seat.
Yep.
Look at that guy. See, so whenever they're taking long, you don't ever want to pull back. You see how the rod's coming up, the tip's coming up? That's my opportunity to gain line. Yeah, right there.
Look at that angle, man. That's sick.
It's kind of nice taking a seat.
Yeah, I bet, right?
Like, you know, I grew up fishing Southern California saltwater, which is a very macho fishing culture. Never used a rod belt. You know, we call those punani belts growing up. I still won't. And then back in the day, like, using the rail was a no-no. You know, because you can get leverage like that. It's, nah, man, pull on the fish.
It's shaking, isn't it? Does the fight feel different than the rooster?
It really kind of doesn't. It's just the duration is definitely a lot more. All right, so now it's more of a stalemate. So this is when I'm doing the line pinch trick, getting a couple half cranks at a time. Rod up, wind down, rod up, wind down, and as smooth as I can. I don't want to be like herky jerky.
Exactly.
Especially after a long battle.
When you jerk it, that's a perfect opportunity to rip hooks out.
Yep, and you know, we might have worn a big hole in its lip. All it takes is a microsecond of pressure lost and that fish is gone. And I've been pulling on this thing way too long to lose it.
Yeah, we're at 12 minutes now, bud. That's again on one of those moonfish.
Would you call them the upside down fish?
In Florida, they're known as look downs. That's what look people downs, in the States will know that fish as.
Gotcha.
Here we call them moonfish or platin in Spanish. Platin referring to the silvery, really reflective skin they have. Dele, ahí, hit it on toque. Iti with his masterful boat maneuvering in the back, it makes
huge,
a big
man.
Difference.
Huge.
You can really get an edge on the fish.
Yeah, now we're gotta have deep color sink here.
So we're only in maybe 65 feet of water here.
Oh, okay.
70. So we're not really having a big up and down fight. It's a side-to-side fight. No color yet, dude.
No, deep color. Whatever this thing is, it's pretty substantial.
Okay.
What do you got, Ethan? Rooster!
Big rooster.
Oh, yeah, all you gotta do is hit the top.
Yeah, just once. Una vez, sí.
Yeah, perfect. It's got a wide angle, so it'll
yeah.
Get it.
Tiene una cámara, un lente ancho. What do you think, dude? What was the mission when you came to Costa Rica?
Bro, you know, I had a few species in mind when we started talking about me coming down for this trip. You know, I know you guys got some epic tuna fishing here and epic Dorado fishing.
Yeah, but we can fish that anywhere in the world almost.
I catch those at home.
Yep.
You know? It's all about experiencing new things, new food, new friends, new people, new cultures, new nightclubs.
Yeah, buddy.
And new fish species. The rooster fish is top 5 on
my
list coming here. And I wasn't really sure what I was getting myself into as far as, like, region-wise. So I wanted a tarpon.
Yep.
I wanted a snook.
Yep.
I wanted a rooster fish.
Yep.
And I wanted some kind of grouper.
Yep.
Broomtail or...
We got a good shot at that today with that chunk bait.
Sick.
So we're going to go drop some of that on the bottom here soon.
That blue Trevally.
Yeah,
that's me hyped on that.
That's a species that, you know, not many people know about, and it's so beautiful. And yeah, they're in the jack family, but I just love how beautiful they are. And they're delicious.
And it's not even about like, oh, look at me in this hero shot. Like, you know, it's just, every fish is cool, man. Every bite, I've learned to appreciate even the bites from the sabiki rig.
Totally.
Because this wouldn't be happening right now.
Exactly. Exactly.
You know, it's all part of it, man. And people need to embrace the gray, like my boy Chrysalis says. You know, black is losing, white is winning. Man, this is the gray right now.
Yes, sir.
Literally.
Yeah, we got, what do we got? 50 shades of gray back there, big guy?
Yeah.
More than that.
More than that.
And the rooster's gray, too. Silver and black. Beautiful. Come on, we got to get more fish in the boat, son.
I'm sorry.
No, you're not. You're having a time of a lifetime right now.
I don't think I've stopped smiling in like 3 days.
I haven't seen you stop smiling since you got here.
Like, you guys didn't even see the other day. Like, it was windy, right? Wild. And like, we were tucked in tight to the shoreline and throwing at boiler rocks like I'm used to doing for calicos back at home, man. And I had my buff on, so you guys probably couldn't see. But like, dude, I was loving every second of it. And this is what life is about. You know, like, this is the American dream for sure.
For sure.
Because nobody made this happen except me.
That's right,
and,
buddy.
You know, when you put out the right kind of energy, you attract the right kind of people, like my boy Aaron.
Thanks, bro.
Like Iti. And that's what brings these adventures to life. That's real talk, man.
That is real talk.
Everybody's so afraid to put themselves in a position to be ridiculed or judged, you know? And that's what keeps them from seeing a giant rooster fish on the end of their line.
That's right.
I don't want to get too deep on y'all, but... If I can do this, man. Oh, Jesus.
Oh, this one is substantially bigger, dude. The other one took about, what, 5 minutes at the most?
Oh, yeah.
We're pushing 20 minutes on this one now.
You know, I'm putting quite a bit of pressure on this
thing.
And it keeps sounding. So sick, man. So it's better at capturing these moments.
I just looked back. We got the other bait swimming in the water. Uh-oh. I'm imagining something coming up and smacking it and seeing the whole rod and reel go off the side of the boat.
That was a bit sad, but it'd be worth it. I lost a Tranx last fall just because of my stupidity. You can watch the video here.
Yeah.
All right, here we go.
Here we go.
Nice smooth lifts. There's one head shake. Wind down.
Oh, this over-the-shoulder shots are sick, dude. Ma, hit it un toque para quedar para allá.
Out of my traps, though.
Pretty sexy, dude, for an Asian guy.
Putting on size has always been a struggle, man.
Yep.
Always been malnourished and in need of a sandwich. Here he comes. Big circle underneath. Oh, look at that thing. Putting just enough pressure to keep her head turned so she doesn't get another big run. Oh, she got it. She's digging on me. She's digging on me. Come on.
This is a substantially bigger fish, dude. Substantially bigger. Oh! Battle. Beautiful rooster. That's what it's all about, dude.
Oh my god.
That's the rooster.
Ay, Dios míos.
Ay, Dios mío.
That's a
rooster
sick
fish.
One, dude.
PB rooster fish.
I look. Personal record broken twice in one day.
In like 25 minutes. Didn't see. Oh, God. She's fucking huge.
There we go. All right, sweet, here we go. Yeah.
Can we get the...
Yeah, let's get the release. El otro.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, brother. That's what it's all about. The catch and release is important to conserve these species,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, it is.
So all right, we can come back and catch another one.
We're going to let this bad boy go. Okay, ready? Uno, dos. Slap around the butt.
Oh. Beautiful fish, dude. Beautiful fish. Good job, brother. Yes, sir.
Aaron.
That's why we brought you down to Costa Rica, bro. That's what it's all about.
Gracias. Sick.
Yeah, buddy. Let's go catch some grouper.
Dude. Yeah. I think I'm warmed up.
Yeah, well warmed up. No gym in Costa Rica needed, right?
Nope. Not this lifestyle. Sick, bro.
Here you go, buddy.
Got the captain back here. Throwing the mega bass sport poi. My man's Aaron, Peninsula Fishing. Up in the bow, throwing the popper in a sick rhythm.
Yep.
Out here in the big, beautiful Pacific Ocean. Seeing things I grew up watching from the Galapagos Islands flying around. Sea turtle, manta rays. Crazy experience, guys. Please, please step out of your comfort zones. Holler at your boy. We're gonna be doing trips out here. These experiences need to be shared. Appreciate you guys watching. As always, please comment, like, hit the subscribe button if you haven't already. Hate doing it, man, but sometimes I've got to remind you. Stay tuned. Lots more adventures. This is literally just the beginning. It's crazy. Aim high, dream big, baby. And we out. Sacrifice. Adios.